Gonna build a mountain from a little hill.
Hey guys, and thank you so much for tuning into my channel. My name is The Lady Signer. We are back with another episode of Inama Zoo. And for those who don't know, this is a park we started like several months ago. I have no idea when, but we just never really continued it. Not because I didn't want to or that I ended the series, but just because I wasn't really feeling creative for this zoo. But thanks to someone that was watching my Twitch streams who lives in Africa and was sending me pictures of the Kruger Park, I was just like, oh my god, I just really want to get back to Inama Zoo. I just really felt like I wanted to finish off this zoo. Obviously, I'm not going to finish it in this episode, but we're going to do a lot of changes in this episode. So I started off with like one big habitat for basically all the animals, and I wanted to divide all the areas with natural boundaries for the animals. But the big problem actually was that with like such a big habitat and only a few keepers, you are just not able to keep the habitats clean. It's super big for the keepers to walk from one side to the other side. So yeah, it just annoyed me a little bit that it was not really possible how I wanted it to be. So what I now did was like dividing the areas into several habitats. We still have the big habitat, which also still works. So we have one big habitat on the outside for like smaller animals, such like the black wildebeest, the ostrich, the warthog, the zebra, and the Thompson gazelle. These are now added, but we're definitely going to add more animals to it, obviously. But I wanted to create a separate habitat for the elephants and for the giraffes. So basically, I started off with like a tunnel underneath the main path section for the staff, so I will be able to get like the gates closer to the habitats themselves. So I ended up with like underneath that big dome you see. You can also rewatch how I built that in episode one, of course. I built like this facility building section for our staff to be able to have everything closer and nearby to them to use. So we have a big habitat for the elephants and the giraffes, as I just said. And we also have one big habitat for the hippo section we build in the zoo. Well, I'm not really gonna call it a zoo. It's a wildlife park. I really wanted to have it like this really natural reserve. Not really the feeling of a zoo, but I just really can't avoid like putting in some of the airlock doors for the track ride. So yeah, some things I'm going to try and hide it as much as possible, but some things just don't really feel that natural as you would want it to be. But I just don't feel like I'm able to do what I want to do in this zoo with avoiding using those things. So yeah, I'm just going to use it and try to hide it as much as possible in a later stage. And obviously the track ride itself, we're also going to hide away a lot underneath the ground. You will probably see it every now and then in some areas because I want to see where it's going. But in the end, when everything is finished, most of the track will be completely underneath the ground, really giving the feeling that the car is driving on its own with like a guide going through the wildlife park or something like that. So we have this big waterfall area in the corner of this map. Now, I am thinking, because we spoke about that in one of the episodes, I remember that I wasn't really sure what kind of animals I wanted to add there in that region. And there were a few options. So some people said the Nile monitor, some people said the flamingo, and some also mentioned the Nyala. So I'm probably going to add the Nile monitor there, and hopefully I'm able to put the Nile monitor only in like that water section to get that natural, realistic feeling of the Nile monitor really living there. But that's going to be a challenge because that whole mountain area is a little bit harder to put down a gate for the staff and stuff. But I think with a little bit of creativity, we will be able to manage it and to add the Nile monitor there. Also in the mountains, I was thinking like, is there some kind of hooved animal that is like a really good climber? And I'm unsure actually a little bit, like if most of the African animals are more grassland savanna animals, I'm not really sure. So if there is anyone of you out there that knows like what kind of African animals would really fit in like a mountain area, I would really would love to hear that in the comment section down below. So thank you already in advance for that. So I have for myself a little bit the feeling that maybe on one side we could maybe add the aardvarks, and on one side we could maybe add the okapi. So that was my feeling, but like the okapi will get like a very lush area, and also for the aardvark just a little bit. But I don't know why I found something, I think on the internet or so when googling, like when you go to the Kilimanjaro, you need to be aware that you will also be able to find some aardvarks. I think something like that in between those lines. So that's why I thought like, okay, maybe then the aardvarks. But I'd rather have like the dhal sheep, like a very good climbing hoofed animal. I think that would just be super cool. But I'm just not really sure what kind of animal that should be. And obviously the dhal sheep is not coming from the African region, so that is not the one we can pick. But yeah, I'm just really curious what animal you guys would suggest for that. There are tons of African animals in the game, so I bet that there will be some animal I'm just missing out on that I'm not really sure of that it's really a mountain animal. So a lot of time went into fixing this whole zoo, because once I got like the habitats cleared for the elephant and the giraffe, I had to do a lot of fixing escaping points and stuff, and then they all got babies, and also for the hippos, they got babies, and then I had to do it again. So there were so many escaping points, and that's a downside because you're like really trying to work with a natural boundary. So a lot of elephant grass or like small little rocks that you really don't have the feeling that there is a natural boundary, even that it feels like just one big habitat, but still you're able to keep the certain animals in their section of the zoo. So yeah, I think it's really interesting, but yeah, it takes also a lot of time and fixing to arrange this. Like I had a lot of issues when I added the warthogs. The naughty, naughty warthogs are just incredible naughty, and I had so many issues with them. But in the end, I was able to fix it and to make sure that they were not able to walk everywhere. But still, like if you're working with these kind of natural boundaries, you have to make sure that at least the smaller animals are in like the biggest habitat of them all. It's going to be a challenge when I'm going to add like the wilder animals such as the lion, the African wild dog, and the cheetah. Like seeing a warthog walking in their habitats, that's going to be interesting. But obviously we're playing in sandbox mode, so they won't really kill one another. But I'm curious what is going to happen when I get some warthog babies. I think that's going to be even harder to manage, where they will be able to walk and where not. I already had to remove the ostrich chicks because, yep, just like in my franchise series, it was just incredible hard to keep those guys at the spot you want them to be in. So some animals have contraceptives now because, well, it's just super hard to manage in the zoo I'm trying to build here. So yeah, a lot of fixing during this whole time. I wasn't even recording everything, but yeah, we did a lot of fixing for it. So yeah, as I just mentioned, at the beginning of the ride, I'm probably going to add the cheetah and the African wild dog. Both are more like grassland savanna animals, so I'm probably going to add... I'm probably not going to build like super crazy mountainish areas for them. I'm trying to still stay in the natural biomes, but it's honestly hard. Like we did a lot like focusing on the real biomes of South Africa, but it also really burnt me out in that way. Like there are not that many biomes, and well, there are many biomes, but it was just really hard to get those resembled in the game. And I think that really made it harder for me to continue with this zoo. So I'm trying to let go of that a little bit. Still, I'm obviously using pictures of the Kruger Park as examples and stuff, and then like the real biomes in Africa, but I'm trying to let go a little bit more of the realistic biomes because it's gonna be super hard. And in the end, it's just also about having fun. And I just really want to finish this zoo and don't want to be like, oh yeah, I start a zoo, but I don't finish it. Like, I really always try to finish what I start with, even though it sometimes takes some time, just like this. I'm really going to push myself to finish as many zoos as possible, at least when I speak about sandbox mode. I can't really speak about franchise mode because, well, if you go bankrupt or anything, or just... I don't know, that could be more of a reason to stop building in that zoo. But yeah, especially for sandbox mode, whatever happens, I just really want to try to finish up all my zoos in the end. And I'm just, in general, really happy with how this whole zoo is coming along. It's super beautiful. I did this during a live stream, or I did the beginning of this video during a live stream, so sometimes you see a little bit of like weird images or like me standing still, and then I'm just like, oh, I'm so much enjoying the view here, and it's all so pretty and so beautiful, and it just works really well. And it's just super awesome to finally see some more animals in the zoo, because we actually only had the hippos and the elephants, I think. I'm unsure, actually. I think we only had those two animals, and during the live stream I was like, okay, I'm gonna add this animal, and I'm gonna add that animal, and I'm gonna add this animal, and I had so much fun just adding all these animals, but oh boy, the fixing was kinda a thing. But yeah, in the end, it's totally worth it. Something completely different as what we're doing in City Zoo and like our desert franchise mode. So it's fun to have different types of series going along on the channel. And once this one is finished, we may be able to look into like starting a new sandbox series. But I just am refusing to do anything else new before this one is finished. So yeah. I think we just have to finish this one and create something awesome out of this. And who knows, then maybe we can do like a super modern zoo or something like that. I have no idea yet. Maybe something like with a lot of wood in like a tundra biome. I have no idea, but that's for like in months we talk about. So I'm not going to talk about that too much now. It's just me rambling again. So yeah, without further talking, just enjoy the rest of the speed build video, and I will see you guys at the end of this video to show you guys around. So for those who are new to the channel, welcome to Inama Zoo. Inama means wild animals, so Inama Zoo Wildlife Park. This is the area where we have a big work in progress still, and as I mentioned, like, these airlock doors for the Jeep Safari, I'm going to hide them as much as possible. And the same goes for all of these fences right over here. This is all meant to be going away in a later stage. At least I hope that I'm able to do that, because that is going to be the challenge with all these naughty, naughty, naughty animals. But yeah, so we have this big area right over here with a lot of smaller animals. So a black wildebeest, the ostrich, the warthog, the zebra, and the Thompson gazelle right now. But we're going to add a few more. And they are basically able to walk all the way from this. This section is for them, basically. So the giraffes and the elephants are not able to get in here. But they are able to walk in here. Some of the smaller animals are even able to walk in here. This is the hippo habitat on this side. And yeah, I'm going to try to avoid them for getting into this section, because I want to expand this section for a cheetah habitat. I want to expand this section for a African wild dog habitat. And here in the mountains, we're going to... Yeah, well, as I said, I really would like to know if there is some kind of hoofed animal that we can add here in the mountains, maybe. I'm actually thinking to maybe just add the okapi right over here in a very lush and dense area. And maybe the aardvark on this section. But if you guys have any other tips or suggestions, do let me know in the comment section down below. So for this waterfall section, I want to dedicate this for the Nile monitor. I think it's cool to have at least one kind of reptilian animal in our zoo. So I think when we do some work and we are able to make sure that the Nile monitor is not able to go out of here, I'm really hoping that I'm able to make sure that it stays in the water as much as possible, and maybe a little area right over here if it's not too steep. I don't know. We have to make something to make it work, but I'm super up for that challenge. So yeah, we have this bigger section, and over here we have a new airlock here. There used to be just a track ride going underneath here, but to make sure that the animals were not able to walk from one side to the other side, I added this airlock door for the Jeep Safari underneath here. And I think that fits really well, actually, with the wood pattern we already have here. It matches completely. So yeah, the guests can walk towards here and then look into the hippo habitat, where we now finally have some cute little baby hippos. And we now have this as a separated habitat for the hippos to stay in. So the keeper has like its gate door right underneath here, which you can barely see, which was definitely my intention. Hiding away this one as much as possible because, well, it's not really realistic, but they do need some food and stuff. And as you can see, the warthogs are still able to get into this habitat, and probably baby warthogs too, if we have them already in our zoo. I'm pretty sure they're gonna be a lot of trouble again with the baby warthogs, but we shall see about that. So what I really like about this is that now you barely see it, but this is the habitat for the giraffes and the elephants, and this is the habitat for the hippos. So you can barely tell that these two are separated habitats, and I just really, really like that. You can really barely tell that this is a natural border in between. So that is really cool. So for the giraffes and the elephants, there's also a gate right underneath here, so also that the guests will not really be able to tell that there is a staff keeper gate. But we had to, because I remember when we first put down a lot of elephants, all this poop, and then having keepers coming from only that one door section right in this corner all the way to here to be able to clean it, it was just not doable. So yeah, I just had to do this because, well, there's not really a cheating option where your animals will not poop, do they? And also these kind of things, well, they need food. I might for the last tour maybe delete this or anything, but we just have to live with it. We can't make it like super realistic with all these barrels and stuff. Look at these cute little elephants. They're so adorable. So yeah, we still have a lot of work to do, and but it's coming along quite nicely. It took some time to make sure that we had some really separated areas, but now we have this. I think we can just focus on adding more animals now and finishing off this area with a beautiful waterfall again, and get something cool here with maybe a jungle with some gorillas. So yeah, I'm really excited to start doing some more work in Inanna Zoo, and I'm not gonna put myself on any schedule, so not like, oh yeah, I'm gonna upload this once every week, it's probably once every other week or something like that. Don't pin me on this, but we're definitely going to make a good start of finishing Inanna Zoo. So yeah, do let me know in the comment section down below what you guys think of this new progress in Inanna Zoo. If you have any tips or suggestions, do let me know in the comment section down below. Leave a like at the video if you guys enjoyed, and subscribe, of course, if you haven't already. And I just really hope to see you guys all in the next one. Thank you guys so much for watching. Bye, guys! Se la passe zo a ca.